This quick tutorial will cover how to set up multiple projectors for projection mapping in Resolume Arena 7. I'll be demonstrating how it's done by projection mapping a wedding cake as an example. I'm going to assume you have two projectors correctly connected to your machine. I'm using a MacBook Pro that has two Thunderbolt 2 ports. These enable me to connect my two projectors via mini display port to HDMI cables. If you don't have two video outputs from your machine, you could always buy additional hardware to split one output into two. Multi-display adapters like the Dual Head2Go can do this. I've included a link in the description. Mac users, open Display in System Preferences. On the Arrangement tab, make sure Mirror Displays is turned off. Windows users, to set up the display, right-click on the desktop and select Display Settings. On the Settings tab, make sure your displays are in Extended Desktop mode. I'm also going to assume you have some familiarity with setting up screens and using slices in Resolume's Advanced Output. If you're not comfortable using these features, I'd recommend you click on the card and watch my beginner's tutorial on getting started with projection mapping in Resolume. The first thing you might see upon opening Resolume Arena 7 is this example composition. I'm going to start a new composition. I'll bring in the content I want to map to my cake by dragging it into a clip slot. I'll change the comp settings to match my content, which is 1080 by 1080. Next, I'm going to go to Advanced Output and load my wedding cake preset. Again, you can see how I created this by watching the tutorial on the card a moment ago. What we're looking at here in the Input Selection tab are slices defined for each visible face of a tier. And in the Output Transformation tab, I've moved the corner handles of the slices to map the content to the physical surfaces of the cake. But this is for one projector handling all the surfaces of the cake. Now I want to add another one. In Resolume lingo, any output is called a screen. You can see we have one screen, screen 1. And we've assigned it a device, in my case a projector. Here it's display 2. Display 1 is my laptop display, and we can see display 3, which is my second projector, ready to be put to work. So all you need to remember is that a screen just means an output. For us, it's a projector, but for someone else, it might be an LED screen or a monitor. So we need a second screen. I add it by hitting the plus and choosing screen. Now I have screen 2, and right now it has a virtual output because I haven't assigned it a device. I will now, and I'll assign it display 3. Now I can see from what each projector is outputting, and by toggling off the visibility, which display is the projector to the left of the cake and which one is to the right. It so happens that display 2, for me, is the projector hitting the left side of the cake, and display 3 is hitting the right side. I'll rename this screen left, and screen 2 I'll call right. Now I want to move all the slices that relate to the right side of the cake into the right screen. I'll delete the slice that was created automatically with the screen. Now I go through the process of mapping the corners of the slices to the physical surfaces of the cake in the Output Transformation tab and selecting Edit Points. If you like the video content I've been using, you might want to take a look at my shop, where I sell animations, loops, and templates for cake mapping. Follow the link by clicking the card. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. If this video helped you, please hit that like button. Subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out on future cake mapping and projection mapping tutorials and videos.